Yeah. And I saw it like a vision, like a clearly painted picture. The words of our past, of our present and our future. For him that I read it, took a run and tell him, homeboy, you tune into the truth, now learn what to do now. Whatsoever things written aforetime, time, we're written so that we could have hope, preserved through the times till the day we awoke, we awake now. Ain't no excuse, got no enemy watching, send me on the tower. Satan walk about, seeking whom he made a power. So we gotta stay sober every hour on the hour. Gotta stay sober every hour on the hour. I'ma tell you this now, we ain't in the corner no more. We ain't in the corner no more. Thine eyes shall see thy teachers, thine ears shall hear, this is the way. We ain't in the corner no more. 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 Thine eyes shall see thy teachers, thine ears shall hear, this is the way.
You Native American Indians, you Bahamians, and you Jamaicans, you are the biblical Israelites according to the Bible. Alright? You are the true Jews according to the Bible. You are the people that Mosai died, sent his son and died for. Alright? I want Acts. I should have told you this before. Acts 20 and verse 32. Acts 20 and 32. Alright? You are God's chosen people. And knowing that is what? It's only 50% of the battle. Knowing who you are is only enough to what? To allow you to know what else is next, what else you need to do, and what else you need to what? Apply to your life. Read. The book of Acts, chapter 20 and verse 32. And now, brethren, I command you to God, and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up. So, what? The apostles knew what we needed to do. Read that again. Verse 32, and now, brethren, I command you to God, and to the word of his grace. So now, brethren, I command you to God, and to the word of his grace. Read on. Which is able to build you up. Which is able to what? To build you up. What is the Bible able to do for the blacks, Hispanics? To build you up. What is the Bible able to do for the Bahamian man? To build you up. It is able to build us up. It is able to build what? This country up. The minds of our people. Give me Psalms 111 and verse 10. The Bible is able to build our people up. How? And why? Because our people are in a low state of mind. We are the people that are what? Bogged down on drugs. Bogged down on Christianity. What is this Bible able to do for us? It's able to build us up in the spirit of the Messiah Christ. Read. The book of Psalms, chapter 110 and verse 111 and 110.
Right.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding of all they that do his command. The Bible says the fear of God is the beginning of the commandments, man. The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Read. His prayers endure forever.
Read that verse again.
Verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding of all they that do his command.
Whoa.
So the Bible says the fear of God, meaning fear in the Most High and what? How he can judge you if you break his commandments. The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom, man. A good understanding of all that I what? All that do his commandments. All they that apply God's commandments. All they that what? That study to show themselves approved. Give me that in 1 Timothy.
That's right.
Give me that in 2 Timothy, I think it is. 2 and 15. So fearing God and keeping his laws is what gives you the wisdom.
Is that it?
Fearing God is what gives you the wisdom to know how to what? How to apply it to your life. How to become spiritual. Spiritual. Read that. The book of 2 Timothy is chapter 2 and verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God. Study to show yourself approved unto God. Because guess what? You are not inclined to get wisdom if you don't study. It's what the Bible is saying.
Read it again.
Verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God. A workman that needed not to be ashamed. And you know what? What's funny is that a lot of the apostles, you remember what? They discussed the scriptures a lot. They discussed the scriptures many times, frequently it says. So what is that example for us? We have to study the Bible for ourselves. We can't set up in a church and allow men to lie to us. The Bible says to read, to seek ye out of the book of the law. Hold on right there. And give me Isaiah 34:16, right quick. The Bible says to study to show ourselves approved unto God. That's how we want. That's how we're able to what? Be able to defend our gospel. Because brothers and sisters, if you say you stand for the Christ, if you say you stand for the Most High God, you must be able to what? You gotta study. You gotta be able to show yourself approved. Read. The book of Isaiah, chapter 34 and verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord. And read. Seek ye out of what? Out of the book of the Lord. And read. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. What is the book of the Lord today? You ask any man, what's the book of the Lord? And got no one here asking, huh? What is the book of the Lord? The Bible. The Bible is the book of the Lord. The Bible is the top-selling book of the earth. Google it. Read it again. Verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail. Meaning none of the prophecies of the Most High God is going to fail. Look what's happening in Israel. Look what's happening in the Middle East. That is foretold in the scriptures. The Bible says none of these things are what? Are going to fail. But you are not going to understand. You are not going to know if you don't study the Bible. We have to study the scriptures to what? To show ourselves approved unto God. Go back to where I had you. Go back to where I had you. Read that again. The book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2 and verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God. A workman that needed not to be ashamed. Rightly divided the word of truth. The Bible says rightly dividing the word of truth. Rightly dividing the word of God. Because you know what? You go to these Christian churches and they tell you, that ain't gonna run. 1 Corinthians 3. I love God. 1 John 3:5. I love God. Right? I guess what? They don't understand precept upon precept. Give me that in Isaiah chapter 28. That quick to go to John chapter 3 and verse 16 and say, well, you know, brother, God loved the world. God loved all nations. Is that so? That's not rightly dividing the word of truth. You got it? Read it. Verse 10. Read verse 10.
Okay. The book of Isaiah chapter 29. The book of Isaiah, chapter 28 and verse 9. Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine?
So, who is that man and who is that woman that the Most High is going to allow to make what? To understand his knowledge, to understand the Bible, to understand what is going on in the scriptures, rightly dividing the word of truth. Read.
Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast.
So look, the Bible says, whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Meaning to understand the word of God. To understand what? The prophecies in the Bible. To understand what is it you need to do to get the kingdom of heaven. What did it say?
For a precept must be upon precept.
Now read that.
Read that, read that. After doctrine.
Them that are weaned from the milk. And drawn from the breast.
Hold that.
Give me 2 Peter 2:2. 1 Peter 2:2.
So it says, look, them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast is what? Is whom the Most High is going to give that understanding to. Is whom the Most High is inclined to show the true word of the Most High to. And what it's really talking about in the Bible. Because you know what? A lot of our brothers and sisters today don't understand a thing that is going on in the scriptures. Christianity has defiled our minds, man. Is that what I want? Yeah, read verse 2.
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 2 and verse 2.
Read it.
As newborn babies desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
That ye may grow thereby. So what was the word that Isaiah 28 was talking about? What was that sincere milk? That's talking about the commandments. When you read 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 2. As newborn babies, meaning when you come into this knowledge, you have to learn all over again, brothers. You have to learn all over again, sisters. It says, as newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word. Meaning what? The applications of the commandments. That's what we read back in Psalms 11, verse 10. It says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning. Meaning what? That's how you what? Start to understand. That's how you start to get wisdom. That's how you what? Are inclined to learn the Bible. Read it again.
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 2, and verse 2. As newborn baby desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
That ye may what?
Grow thereby.
That's how you're going to grow in the spirit of the Most High in Christ. Go back to where I had you. That's how you're going to grow in this word. How you gonna grow in wisdom, knowledge, and understanding? Now what? You Bahamians and you Jamaicans, you are the Israelites. You are the Israelites. And what we need to do is come back to the commandments of God. And when we apply God's commandments, it's how we what? Learn the scriptures. It's how we get wisdom. It's how we get understanding. Read it again.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 28 and verse 9. Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast.
Meaning them that are what? Them that are keeping the commandments. Them that are learning of the commandments of God. Read.
For precept must be upon precept. Uh-huh. Precept upon precept.
Read.
Line upon line.
Read.
Line upon line. Here a little and there a little.
Whoa. So the Bible says, for precept must be upon precept. Meaning a scripture applies with another scripture. Line upon line. Meaning what? Let's go back to that. That scripture we read in Timothy's? Rightly dividing the word of truth. It says line upon line. Here a little and there a little. Because you know when we go over the Bible and there are many brothers and sisters that ask us this question. They say, why are those brothers jumping from the book of Isaiah down to the book of Revelation? Why are they jumping all over the Bible? It's because you have yet to understand how to read the Bible. The Bible is not supposed to be read like a novel. You can do it, but you won't get the understanding thereof. That's why the Bible says rightly dividing the word of truth. It's almost like a puzzle. You gotta find what scripture matches up with another scripture in the Bible. That's how you get what? The understanding thereof. And the application of the commandments is what? How you able to what? Bestow it upon your people to teach them the Bible. Read it again.
Verse 10. For precept must be upon precept. Precept upon precept.
Read.
Line upon line. Line upon line. Here a little and there a little.
So precept must be upon precept. Here a little and there a little. So that's how we what? How we study the scriptures, man. That's how we get the understanding of the Bible. Give me Romans chapter 7. Romans chapter 7.
Huh? Yeah, drop him.
Romans 7, read verse 14.
Romans 7 and 14.
Let's see what the Bible is able to do for us. Because in the application of God's commandments, that's how we get what? Wisdom. I know a lot of you want wisdom today. A lot of you need wisdom. Myself included. Read.
The book of Romans chapter 7 and verse 14. For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal, sold unto sin.
So we know that the law is spiritual, meaning the commandments of God. That's how we what? Spiritually get the wisdom and understanding thereof. It says, but I am carnal, sold unto sin. Because all of us are what? Born in that simple state of mind. Who taught a baby how to rob, how to lie, how to cheat, how to steal? None of that stuff comes naturally. Those things come naturally. That's why what? We have to be able to what? Study the Bible and to learn how to what? How to break off from those things. How to what? How to apply God's commandments. How to what? How to stop breaking the commandments is what is needed. And when you do those things, that's how you get the wisdom. That's how you're able to get wisdom. Read. Give me First Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 21. And when we also study the Bible, what else is able to come to us? What else is able to be done? The Bible says to study to show ourselves approved, brothers and sisters. We have to study the scriptures to show ourselves approved unto who? Unto the Christian pastor?
That's right.
Unto man. No, unto God. Read. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. What else is studying to show ourselves approved going to benefit us? Read.
The book of Thessalonians, chapter 5 and verse 21.
Read.
Prove all things.
Prove what?
All things.
No, some things.
All things.
Prove all things. Read.
Hold fast that which is good.
So it says to prove all things in the Bible. How are you able to prove all things? The only way you can prove all things is by studying to show yourselves approved. To to study the Bible to yourselves. That's how you were able to what? To show yourselves approved unto God. Read it again. Verse 21. Prove all things.
Prove what?
Prove all things. Hold fast that which is good. And it says to hold fast to that which is good. What is good according to the Bible? Drop that. Romans 7 and 12. The Bible says to prove all things. Remember we read back in what? First Peter said what? We have to be able to study to show ourselves approved. We have to be able to what? To rightly divide the word of truth. How is it that you're going to know what precept comes with another precept if you don't study the Bible when you leave your time? Because sure, it's good to go and listen to men talk to you about the Bible. I mean, should you say what? By hearing the word come with faith. By what? A brother teaching you is how you're going to get the understanding. But that's not it. You have to search out for yourself.
Read.
The book of Romans chapter 7 and verse 12. So remember it says to prove all things and to hold fast to that which is good. What is good according to the Bible? Read. Wherefore the law is holy, and the commandment holy, and just, and good. So it says, wherefore the law of God is holy. You want to be holy? Keep the laws of God. It says, wherefore the law is holy, and the commandments holy, and just, and what? And good. And what? And good. So the Bible is good. The only thing good in this earth is the keeping of the commandments. That's the only thing that is good upon the earth. So what you need to hold fast to, brothers and sisters, is the laws of God. Keeping the commandments of God is how you what? Understand the scriptures. Give me 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 11. 1 Peter 4 and 11. That's the reason, that's how you what? Able to understand what's going on in the scriptures. Why is the Middle East getting blown up by the Palestinians? Why is Israel going through such turmoil? Why are their children dying in the Middle East? I don't know how to study the Bible. The only way you can understand is if you study the scriptures on what? And watch. Here's what the Bible says. Read. The book of 1 Peter, chapter 4, and verse 11.
Come on.
If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God.
Read it again.
If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God.
If any man speak,
our sermon from his heart. Is speaking the word of God?
Read
it again. Verse 11.
Read.
If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man has the audacity to speak the Bible, he's supposed to speak the oracles of the Most High. He's supposed to what? Precept upon precept. That's how he's supposed to show the people the truth of the Bible. That's how he's supposed to what? Bestow knowledge to the people. To you. Notice how we speak. We speak as the oracles of the Most High God. Read it again. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. So it says what? You gotta speak the oracles of God.
That's right.
You gotta speak the words of God. If you don't speak the words of God, who's gonna believe you? I'll tell you who's the person that's not gonna believe you. A man that does not study at all. A brother or sister that does not study at all is a person who's going to believe you. Read on. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God give it. Whoa, that's a heavy verse. Read it again. If any man minister, the Bible says if any man is able to minister, we got ministers in church. We got ministers in church. Funny. Read it again. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God give it.
Right.
So who ultimately makes us ministers of this Bible? Who ultimately is the highest power to make us ministers? The Bible. God is the one that ordains the ministers of this Bible. It says if any man wants to be that minister, to restore knowledge to his people, he got to speak the oracles of God. Yeah. Which the God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ.
Right.
In which the God in all things may be glorified through the Christ, through the Spirit of the Most High in Christ. Because you know what? The Christian pastors, they do it to glorify themselves.
That's right.
Look at the man, Miles Monroe and whatever else other guys in, Neil Anderson. Those brothers are doing it for themselves. Yep. They're mega churches. Making books for themselves. They got the damn, next to their Bible churches, they got their own selling books. on how to study the Bible when the people are supposed to what? Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. We read that in Isaiah 34. Give me back, go back to Psalms 111 and verse 10. Right? So we gotta speak to all because of the Most High God, man. And in able doing that, and doing that, we're able to what? To gain wisdom. Like I said before, I know a lot of you want wisdom today. The only reason you're gonna get wisdom is if you what? Keep the commandments. That's it. Read. The book of Psalms, chapter 111 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Whoa, read.
A good understanding of all that are to his commandments.
So the Bible says, look, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding of all that are to his commandments. Because the doctrine is keeping the commandments. Give me that in Proverbs 4 and 2. The doctrine of God is what? Christianity ain't the doctrine. Newsflash, Christianity is not the doctrine.
That's right.
Islam is not the doctrine. Rastafarianism is not the doctrine. What is the doctrine of God?
On the flyer, brother.
Let's read. The book of Proverbs, chapter 4 and verse 2. And notice when we go to explain something, we go out the Bible. Like God said to. Read.
For I give you good doctrine.
For I give you what?
Good doctrine.
Good what?
Doctrine.
Doctrine. Read.
Forsake ye not my law.
Forsake ye not what?
My law.
What are the Christian pastors not teaching today?
My law.
My law. God says to keep his laws. His laws. His laws. That's the reason our people are what? Are bugged out of Christianity. That's the reason why. What? Our brothers and sisters are what? Get a gun, get a Glock 40 and shoot us on the brother. Read it again.
Verse 2. For I give you good doctrine.
God says he already gave us good doctrine. Christianity is a new doctrine in the earth. God says he already gave good doctrine. Read.
Forsake ye not my law.
Forsake ye not my law. The laws of God is the doctrine that what? We're supposed to keep today.
Okay.
Believe it or not.
No dollar now.
Read on.
For I was my father's son.
Read that again. Verse 2.
For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law.
So the Bible says I gave you good doctrine. I gave you good doctrine. The doctrine that Most High gave us was what? The keeping of the commandments of the Most High God. Because that's the thing he what? He wanted us to do. Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. That's the only thing God required of us. To fear him and keep his commandments through the Son Christ. You got it?
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
Whoa, so God says, and now, O Israel, what does the Lord require of you?
Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways.
Look, so remember the God of heaven and earth gave us good doctrine. He says, look, what does the Lord require of us? But to fear him, I keep his commandments. Read on.
And to love him.
Read.
With all thy heart, and with all thy soul.
So what is it to love God? You know what I want. Hold on right quick. First John 5 and 3. Because the Christian goes to church and say, yo, I love Jesus. I love Jesus, right? I never know what it means to love God. What does the Bible say to love the Most High God? How is it that you love God? You gotta apply his commandments. Let's prove that. Read.
The book of 1 John chapter 5 and verse 3.
This is how you love the Most High. Read.
For this is the love of God.
For this is the love of what?
Of God.
Read.
That we keep his commandments.
That we what?
Keep his commandments.
Yes, we have to keep the commandments of the Heavenly Father.
That's right.
Love God. Love, love, love. How do you love God? You keep his commandments. You keep his commandments. Go back to Deuteronomy 10 and 12. And keeping the commandments is how we get the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the scriptures. Oh, you gotta believe it. You gotta keep God's commandments. You gotta stop breaking the Sabbath day. You women, you gotta stop wearing pants. You men, you gotta grow a beard. You gotta wear the fringes. That's keeping the laws of God. That's how you show you love God. That's how you get wisdom. Read it again. Verse 12.
And now, Israel, what that the Lord thy God require of thee?
Because you're the Hamans, you are the Israelites. You are the God-chosen people. Come on.
But to fear the Lord.
But to fear what?
To fear the Lord,
the
Lord.
To fear the Lord our God. Read.
To walk in an honest way.
And to fear God, meaning you walk in His judgments, you walk in His ways. Because if you walk in the ways of God, if you fear Him, the Most High is inclined to be with you. He's inclined to give you mercy, understanding of the Bible. Read.
And to love Him.
And to what?
And to love Him.
So you love God by showing that you keep His commandments. Read on.
With all thy heart.
Uh-huh.
And with all thy soul.
Read.
To keep the commandments of the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
And the statutes.
Uh-huh.
Which I command thee this day.
Because you know what? Our people agreed to keep the commandments of God. Give me that in Deuteronomy 27. It's the last verse. Our people what?
26.
26?
27 or 26.
Believe it or not, your forefathers agreed to keep God's commandments. Your forefathers agreed to keep the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. Your forefathers agreed to love God. But what do? Because of not studying. Because of not believing. We broke His commandments. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 27 and verse 26.
Read.
Cursed be all that confirm it. Not...
Take your time, read it again.
Verse 26.
Read.
Cursed be he that confirm it not all the word of the of this law. To do them.
Right. The Bible says, cursed be the man, cursed be the woman that confirm it to not all the laws. To confirm it that what? You don't confirm the commandments. You willfully break God's commandments. You don't give a damn about God. The Bible says, cursed be he. Read.
And all the people shall say, Amen.
And all the people shall say, Amen. Meaning your forefathers agreed to keep the law, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father. Your forefathers agreed for that. That was us. Our forefathers agreed to keep God's commandments. Well, look at us today. Look at why our societies are so ridden with drugs and homosexuality and diseases and sin. I mean, look what's going on in the United States. Look what's going on in Africa. You got Ebola virus going around, right? I know a lot of people are scared of that thing. A lot of people are scared of that thing. You know why that's happening? You know why the stuff in the Middle East is happening? Because you to this day will not keep the laws, statutes, and commandments.
That's right.
You to this day are rebellious as hell. Give me that Deuteronomy 28 verse 61. You wonder why AIDS and Ebola and all these sickness and diseases and cancer and prostates? Why all this is happening to our people today? Because you failed, you what? You failed to keep the commandments of God.
That's right.
You rejected God's commandments. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 61.
Let's go.
Also every sickness and every plague,
uh-huh,
which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
It says, look, every sickness and every plague which the Lord brought upon us, man, is because we didn't keep the commandments. Every sickness and every plague, which is not even written in the book of the law, because cancer was written in the book of the law. Gonorrhea wasn't written in the book of the law. Syphilis wasn't written in the book of the law. AIDS wasn't written in the book of the law. Every sickness and every plague which was not written in the book of the Holy One was brought upon our people, was brought upon the Israelites. Because you blacks and Hispanics, you are the biblical Israelites. You are God's chosen people. God only loves you. I need you to understand that. Read. Is that it? Read that.
Verse 61,
yeah.
Also every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of the law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
Right. And those are the things which God bring upon us, so what? That we may be destroyed. Give me Hebrews 2 and 1. I lie. Romans 15 is verse 14. Romans 15 and 4.
Romans 15 and 4.
So that's how what? God destroyed us. The Most High God threw these diseases on us, these plagues on us, because we refused to keep His commandments. Yeah, God did that. Satan didn't do that. God did that.
That's right.
Satan had a damn thing to do with that. If he what? He was orchestrated by the Lord to do that. But who ultimately did that to us? God. Because why? We didn't break it. We didn't keep His commandments.
And you know what? Our people still have known this thing. You know why we don't know it no more? Because we don't keep the commandments of God. Because we do not study to show ourselves approved. All these things that are happening to us today, we didn't study. We don't understand. We didn't study to show ourselves approved.
That's right.
So that's why it's happening to us. Read on. The book of Romans, chapter 15 and verse 14.
Come on.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime.
Yeah.
Were written for our learning.
So the Bible says, whatsoever things were written aforetime was written for our learning. Whatsoever things were written aforetime was written for our learning. Oh.
So what? The fact that you blacks and Hispanics, you are the Israelites, it's written for our learning. The fact that we have to keep the commandments of God is written for our learning.
That's right.
The fact that what? We should have known all of these curses would have happened upon us, would have happened to our people today. It's written in the Bible. We should have known that. It was written for our learning. The fact that we want what? We should have known. All of these things were written for our learning. Read on. That we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. Oh, and the Bible says that we through patience, and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. Because in learning these things now, we are able to be comforted by the Spirit of Christ. That we are the Israelites. That we are going to get the kingdom next. We got next, brothers. The kingdom is for us. We should have known these things by studying and applying the commandments of God. Read that one more time. The book of Romans, chapter 15 and verse 4.
Read it.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime, were written for our learning.
Written for our learning, read.
That we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
So you want hope, black man? You want hope, Hispanic? And Native American man? You gotta keep God's commandments. You gotta study and show yourselves approved unto God. Because going in those 40 Christian churches, they will not teach you a damn thing.
That's right.
They won't teach you anything according to the Bible. So study to show yourselves approved. If any man speak, let him speak the oracles of God. And with that we say shalom. Most High Christ bless.